We have published this paper on behalf of the International Society of Liquid Biopsy with all the other people that participate in this fascinating society, and we address the issue of implementation of liquid biopsy not only in clinical practice but also in clinical research, because we can use this tool to improve the quantity of patients that we can analyze to introduce in clinical practice. And in particular for non-small cell lung cancer, liquid biopsy represents a really fascinating tool that we can use in clinical setting, but with some differences among different countries. For example, at European level, we have the possibility to analyze EGFR mutation for non-small cell lung cancer. In USA, you have two different devices approved for liquid biopsy, not only in non-small cell lung cancer, but also in different type of solid tumors. But one of the most important points is the comprehensive analysis of all clinical relevant alterations by using liquid biopsy, not only DNR-based like as EGFR, BRAF or KRAS, but also for gene fusions like as ALK, RET, N3K, another type of clinical relevant alteration different from this, like as mutation in exon 14 or MET for exon skipping 14 or MET. And the use of liquid biopsy in this setting is really important because it gives us the possibility not only to be static like as tissue, but also to be dynamic, and we can follow up this type of alteration during the time.